Sri Sairam. My humble and wholehearted pranams at his lotus feet, the lotus feet which is so close to each one of our hearts. The word Swami literally means master. When we call him master, we are all subjugating ourselves to him. It is an expression of total surrender. I think all of us are doing that, and we've experienced this in our lives several times. When I close my eyes and think about Swami, the most important facet that comes through is his love. His love permeates everything. Millions of devotees across the world have had amazing experiences. But the underlying factor in each of these, if I can call it glorious experiences, is Swami's love. Swami's love is more than the love of a million mothers. And we have all experienced this. I'm just sharing a couple of experiences that I have had. I was not born into a family which had heard a lot about Swami. We were a religious and pious family, but the turning point came when my aunt, my father's first cousin, she was in Delhi, when they moved to the south after their retirement. My aunt had had very, very close interactions with Swami, and she was totally blessed. She introduced Swami to us all. Miracles used to take place in my aunt's house. When I went to her house for the first time, I saw Vibhuti on pictures, something I've never seen before. I asked her, "What is all this?" And just as I was asking, Vibhuti started pouring out. I was startled, not even startled, I was scared. Slowly, my aunt introduced me to the world of Swami. In fact, she introduced all of us to the world of Swami. And for this, I'm so eternally grateful to her. And there's been no looking back since then. My husband is a very good man, but when we got married, he was a total non-believer. He believed in gods, but he didn't recognize the Supreme God, our Swami. When I got married, my father was posted as the head of the Madurai Medical College and Hospital. And I was working in a college, in the maths department, in Lady Doe College. The wedding was fixed at Chennai, our hometown. As both my parents were doctors, they had a lot of contacts. It was decided that, you know, a reception could be arranged in Madurai after the wedding. My mother left a few weeks earlier to Chennai to overlook and to oversee the wedding preparations. My dad and me left just 5 days before the wedding, as I had to submit my resignation, I had to finish my portions, etc. So we went, the wedding went off, and we all returned with my husband to Madurai for the reception. And when we opened the door of the house, a striking fragrance of Vibhuti was there. My mother was very meticulous, and she just looked at me and my dad and said, "In the hurry that when you were leaving, you must have either left the box open or you must have put it down." So we went in to the puja room. There was a photo of Swami, which my aunt had given. And my mother had placed our wedding invitation at his lotus feet before she left for Chennai. And the whole shelf was full of Vibhuti. It's just like a mound of Vibhuti. I just can't forget that sight in my life. My mother thought it was a blessing. And so when she came with us to Bombay to help me set up house, She brought this picture and placed it at the altar. I think after a couple of hours, my husband saw this and he was very agitated. He told my mother, please take this picture back. And my mother and me, I was so very upset. I said, this is an indication of Swami's blessings and I am not going to let go of that picture. But then my mother, you know, seeing that my husband was very worked up, she just quietly packed this, and which I didn't want her to do, and she put it away. And when she left, she told me, when Swami wants to enter your house, he will come. So let this not be a source of fight. Swami will not like this. So I didn't like it. I was very upset, but I just swallowed it and kept quiet. Days, months passed by. At that time, a senior IAS officer from Delhi had a heart attack while he was holidaying in Kodaikanal. Madurai is the closest large city, and my father so went there by ambulance to get him to the airport for airlifting him to Delhi because he wanted to be treated only at AIMS. He settled him in the aircraft, checked his vital parameters, and came out into the airport. And he saw a large crowd in one section of the airport. And as he turned around, he saw Swami getting down from an aircraft. My father was delighted, but he was nowhere close to Swami. He was far away. He found out that Swami was going to Kodaikanal. He decided that this ambulance was anyway going to Kodaikanal. So let's go. It was a Sunday and the year was 1983. And there were no cell phones, were not in vogue in those days. So he came home and he told my mother that we are going to see Swami in Kodaikanal. My mother was delighted. She said, I didn't even change my sari. I just got into the ambulance and reached Sai Shruti in Kodaikanal. They were just at the gate when Swami came out to get into his car. There was no one except a few sevadals. So they tried to move towards Swami's car. Swami waited for them and he very lovingly asked them in Tamil, nobody knows I'm here. How did you know? And smiled his very charming smile. He held my father's shoulders and he was speaking to them. And I was expecting my first child then. And so my mother told Swami, please bless Priya. And he told my mother, what is there if the photo is not there? I am always there with Priya. Why do you worry? He spoke for a few minutes and they were elated and then they returned. Years rolled by. My husband was slowly thawing down, but not, we didn't have a picture of Swami in our house. During Diwali one year, the Tamil publications would come out with very colorful, huge editions, you know, different magazines. So I had just bought one for my mother-in-law. My in-laws were visiting us from Chennai for Diwali. In the book, I saw a huge, you know, beautiful picture of Swami. You know, he was reclining and with his Abhayahasta. And I loved it. So I cut it and kept it. And one day when I was in the market, I gave it to a shop for framing. But I was hesitant to tell my husband. You know, I didn't know how he would receive this. But one day, I didn't want an uproar when my in-laws were there. And so one day I told him, see, I saw a picture and I gave it. He didn't say anything. He didn't react at all. But then I ran to Chembur station so many times, but you know, it slipped me to collect that picture or to bring it back. One day we had to, run a very small errand and we didn't take our car. We went by scooter. And this was almost about maybe 1.5 months after I had given the picture for framing and I had not yet collected it. We finished our work and we were you know, just about to leave, and my husband pointed across the road, and you know, the usual photo framing shop was where we normally used to give our pictures in those days. And because at that time there were no, you know, e-pictures. And he said, did you give the photo here for framing? I've not seen it. Did you collect it? I said, no, I've not yet collected it. He said, okay, you wait here. I'll just run across and get the photo. And that photo was about 2.5 feet wide by, I think, 2 or 1.5 feet wide. It's a big one. And so I said, no, we'll take it when we get the car. No, not in the scooter. So he said, see, we have hardly anything. We've not purchased anything. So you can just sit at the back, keep Swami's photo, you know, on your lap. And it's a short distance, about 2.5 kilometers. So it shouldn't, it should be pretty comfortable. So with a picture of Swami on my lap, we started back. And there's a place, if you know Mumbai, it's called Diamond Garden, where 4 main junctions meet. We had just crossed the signal, and in a short while, we would be home. So as we were crossing the signal, we were nearly through, and we saw a car coming, you know, in from the perpendicular direction at great speed. I thought that the car would see the red light and it would stop. But it didn't. Apparently, I think the driver had lost control. He couldn't. But my husband saw this and he accelerated. So we were through. Just a few seconds and we would have crossed. And the car hit the tail of the scooter. The impact was so great because we were also traveling at an accelerated speed. And we just went, hit the divider, and we were thrown on the road. The scooter, the photo, my glasses, my watch, and both of us lying in different parts of the road. The policemen and so many passers-by rushed there to help us. They thought that there was going to be a big damage. But my husband got up and he just brushed himself. And I too just got up and brushed myself. I couldn't see clearly because I didn't have my glasses on. The policeman bought the photo. He handed me the Swami's photo, my glasses, my watch. Nothing was damaged. There was not a scratch on any. I don't know how. I still can't imagine how this happened. Only there was a slight bend in the fork of the scooter, but we were able to get onto the scooter. And I mean, we were startled and shocked, but we were able to reach home. This is how Swami's photo entered our house. And this and many more incidents, you know, firmed up my husband's faith. And today I should say, he's a stauncher devotee, I would say, than even I am. What more can I say of Swami's grace and Swami's love? I experience it every day, that from simple things to, you know, huge episodes, troubles, miseries, Swami is just holding not only my hand, everyone's hand, and seeing us cross eternally and eternally indebted to our Lord. Let us pray to him to protect the universe during this pandemic. Samasta loka sukhino bhavantu. Om Sai Ram.